Hi everyone, my name is Thomas Kim. Today is September 4th, 2019. This is my 23rd episode about C# programming for desktop application using Windows Presentation Foundation. In this episode, we will learn about Windows Presentation Foundation content model and content property attribute, custom control, and object property XAML syntax. I highly recommend you to read this document. By reading this document, you can learn more about content model for Windows Presentation Foundation. Without further ado, let's get started. Start Visual Studio 2019. Go to File, New, Project. Select Language, C#, Platform, Windows, Project Type, Desktop. Select WPF App .NET Framework. Select this template. Click Next. Project name, Content Model XAML. Solution name will be Content Model Solution. Click Create. In main window.xml file, scroll down. I will delete grid. Then I will set stack panel like this. Here, button content, button 1, button 2. So I created two button. One is button 1, another is button 2. Please note that in this case, we use the content attribute, and in this case, we fill the content, button 2. Or I can modify text like this. Save it. In this stack panel, we added two buttons, button 1 and button 2. Button 1 and button 2 are contents of stack panel. If we press Ctrl F5, we have this application. Now I will add two text box 1 and another text box 2. Please compare two text box. In this case, we used text attribute to set text box 1 property here. In this case, we used text box contents like this. So in case of button, if we compare this button and this text box, in case of button, contents attribute is the contents of this button. In case of text box, text attribute is the contents of this text box. In case of button, contents attribute is the contents of this button. In case of text box, attribute text is the contents of text box. Now I will set background color of this text box 1 like this. Background aqua. Okay? So background color of text box 1 is changed to color aqua. Now here I can do the same like this too. Text box background. Then aqua. This syntax is called object.property syntax. We need to understand this syntax too. This is attribute syntax. This is object.property syntax. And in this case, background brush has a color attribute. Instead of doing this, we can also make like this. Here, solid brush color aqua. We can also do like this. In case of solid color brush, color is an attribute. I will disable this. Then I can also do like this. Solid color brush, aqua. So this syntax and this syntax is the same. In case of solid color brush, color attribute is the contents. In case of text box, text is the contents. In case of button, contents attribute is the contents of button. At this point, we should have a question. Which property of an object becomes the contents? In case of button, the contents attribute or the contents property becomes the contents. In case of text box object, text property becomes the contents. Which property of the object becomes the contents? I will explain that shortly. Before I explain which property becomes the contents, let's translate it into C# code. Right click, add new project, select WPF app.NET Framework Template, click Next, Content Model Code, click Create, right click, set as Startup Project. Let's close it. I will close all, save. I will open main window jmol.cs and I will also open this file and I will arrange these. I will auto hide. In this class, I will create a function void additional initialization and I will call this function like this. Save all, open this jmol, I will delete grid. Save all, close this jmol file. Here, bar, stack panel, new stack panel. I created a stack panel, application, current, main window, content, stack panel. Now Control F5. So this is our application. We will create a button, bar, button 1, new button, button 1, content, button 1, stack panel. Stack panel has a children property, add button 1, bar, button 2, new, button, button 2, content, button 2, stack panel, children, add button 2. Now press Ctrl F5. Now we added two button, bar, text box 1, new, text box. We created a text box 1, text box 1. It has background color aqua, text box 1. Background color, brushes, aqua, stack panel, children, add, text box 1, bar, text box 2, new, text box 2, text, text box 2, text box 2, background, brushes, Aqua, stack panel, children, add, text box 2, control F5. So it runs exactly the same like this. Please understand that in this XAML syntax, we added 1, 2, 3, 4 elements, 2 buttons, and 2 text box. The contents of this stack panel in this code is children. Once again, the contents of stack panel is children property of stack panel. We added 1 button, 2 button, 1 text box, 2 text box. In case of button, the contents property. In case of text box, text property becomes the contents of this text box. If we want to find out which property of an object becomes a contents property, then please refer to this MSDN documentation. In this page, search for contents property. In case of a button, content is the contents property, and I search again. In case of canvas, children is contents property. In case of dark panel or grid panel and stack panel, children is the contents property. So by referring to this document, we can find out which property of an object is a contents property. In Visual Studio again, close all. In Solution Explorer, right-click the solution, add new project. Select WPF app.NET Framework template again. Click Next. Project name will be Content Property. Click Create. Right-click Contents Property. Set as Startup Project. Right-click. Add New Item. Select WPF. Select Custom Control. My Text Box. Click Add. Here, using System Windows Markup. Using System Globalization. Scroll down. Here, System Windows Markup Contents Property. We put title. Put like this. At this point, we will create a title, public string title. So this title property becomes a content property of my text box object. This attribute specifies title becomes the contents property. String m title my text box. Get return my title. Set m title value. And we will override protected override void on render. Save all. In the XAML here, local my text box title my text box. Now Ctrl F5. So our application runs like this. We cannot see anything yet. Go to my textbox.cs FT new formatted text. The first argument is text to format. It should be M title. The second parameter is cultural info. Cultural info get cultural info EN US. The next parameter is flow direction. Flow direction left to right. The next parameter is typeface. New typeface Times New Roman. EM size 32. Brush. Brush is black. Then pixel per depth. I will put 1.25. So I created the FT formatted text. Then drawing context, this context, draw text. FT formatted text, new point, 10, 10. And FT max text width, this actual width. FT max text height, this actual height. Now press Ctrl F5. So this is my text box. In main window.jml here, we can remove title text. Instead, I love content property. Now press Ctrl F5. So I love content property. So it becomes this text we defined in this class. Title property becomes contents property of this class. I hope you understand this contents property attribute, how it is working. I will upload complete source code to my website csharptalkplayfun.com. By the time you watch this video, you can click this link to download complete source code. If you unzip the downloaded file, you can find the complete source code in this folder. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.